Micaela? Micaela?
The little girl was admitted at about 3 or 4 o'clock this morning. They asked me to come and see her. They were worried about her condition. She was severely dehydrated. Unfortunately, she arrived too late for us to save her.
The young girl died in the cholera treatment center in Tabaje. The center has 70 beds, but is overflowing with patients, like all the other MSF facilities.
The first cholera cases were confirmed on the 19th of October in the Artibonite region in the center of the country. The outbreak quickly spread to the north and reached Port-au-Prince a week ago.
During the first days of the epidemic, the teams were receiving 3 new patients a day in Port-au-Prince. They're now seeing 300 a day.
We're worried that we won't have the capacity to treat all the patients in the coming days. They're arriving in large numbers. Our hospital is completely full. We're even having to refuse referrals because we know we're unable to treat them.
MSF has already treated 15,000 patients for cholera, and Haitian health officials are reporting 917 deaths.
Prevention messages explain that people must wash their hands and drink clean, chlorinated water, but so far they haven't had access to safe water, which is why the epidemic is spreading so quickly.
Although deadly if not treated in time, cholera is a disease that is easy to treat. In the treatment centers, hygiene measures are strict. Patients suffering from watery diarrhea and vomiting are hospitalized generally for 2 days.
This patient has just arrived. He's lethargic. His extremities are very cold and we can't feel his pulse. The skin pinch test is positive, a sign of serious dehydration.
Dr. Sauveur and his colleagues are dealing with a unique situation. Cholera has not struck Haiti for more than 100 years. Unfamiliar with the disease, the epidemic has sparked panic amongst the population.
People don't want us to set up cholera treatment centers near where they live. People reacted by saying, "No, we are going to burn all the centers. We don't want people infected with cholera coming here." People are genuinely frightened.
Patient stigmatization and pressure from the community are further complicating the work of Médecins Sans Frontières.